Good morning to one and all. Surface chemistry. I am very happy to present this lecture in the critical situation of COVID-19 pandemic. So this is very useful. This lecture is very useful for second MSc chemistry students of Bharathidasan University. This slide shows Bharathidasan University syllabus for second MSc students in physical chemistry 2. So surface chemistry and chemical kinetics. So it has two topics, one is surface chemistry and another one is chemical kinetics. So this lecture is planned for second MSc students. I want to read the syllabus, first surface chemistry syllabus. So what is the syllabus? Surface chemistry, surface phenomena, Gibbs adsorption isotherm, solid liquid interfaces, contact angle and wetting, solid gas interface, physics option and chemistry option, Langmuir DET isotherms, surface area determination and kinetics of surface reactions involving adsorbed species, Langmuir Hinshelwood mechanism, Langmuir Rydell mechanism, Rydell Ely mechanism, some interfacial aspects on micelles, reverse micelles, micro emulsions and membrane. Adsorption is a surface phenomenon. Now what is meant by adsorption? Adsorption means that is accumulation of one substance in the surface of another substance. That is called adsorption. So in adsorption there are two types. One is physics option, another one is chemistry options. So physics options, the case of chemistry options, physics option, the characteristics, the bond is van der Waals interaction between adsorbate and adsorbent. So the adsorbent is the substance which adsorbs another substance, that is called adsorbent, and the adsorbate, that is the substance which accumulates on the surface, that is called adsorbate. So in physics option, the bond is a van der Waals interaction, van der Waals force of interaction between adsorbate and adsorbent. So that is one characteristic. Another characteristic, adsorption energy is typically 5 to 10 kilojoules per mole. That is much weaker than a typical chemical bond. So the energy adsorption energy is very low. That is in between 5 and 10 kilojoules per mole. Another characteristic is many layers of adsorbed molecules may be formed. So the adsorption may be polymolecular thickness. So these are the characteristics of physics option. So adsorption and characteristics of physics option, these are shown in this slide. This slide shows various terms in the adsorption surface phenomena. One is adsorbent, that is surface onto which adsorption can occur. So that is adsorbent. That is example, catalyst, surface activated carbon, alumina, etc. And adsorbate, molecules or atoms that adsorb onto the substrate. Example, nitrogen, hydrogen, carbon monoxide and water. So for example, adsorption of oxalic acid on charcoal, the charcoal is adsorbent and oxalic acid is adsorbate. Similarly, another example, adsorption of acetic acid on charcoal, acetic acid is adsorbate and charcoal is adsorbent. Now adsorption, what is the definition of adsorption? That is a process by which a molecule or an atom adsorb onto a surface of a substrate. Here the molecule is adsorbate and the substrate is adsorbent. And coverage means a measure of the extent of adsorption of a species onto a surface. So if we take unit surface area, so total surface area is unit 1, and the theta is a symbol which is a fraction of this one unit area which is covered by adsorbate, here this first figure shows what is adsorbate, what is adsorbent, and the second picture shows the adsorption of adsorbate and the adsorbent. So H is the adsorbate and the surface area of adsorbent is given. So theta is the fraction of surface sides occupied by the adsorbate. So that is theta is the fraction of unit surface area which is covered by adsorbate. This slide shows chemistry option process. So here chemistry options, the characteristics is the adsorption energy is comparable to the energy of a chemical bond. that is one characteristic. Another one is the molecule may comes off intact, that is shown in the left side and the adsorbed process, right? And the right side, the molecule is dissociate and is the atoms are intact with the surface area of the adsorbent. So that is another characteristics. And here the chemical absorption energy is 30 to 70 kilojoules per mole for molecules, and for atoms the chemical absorption energy is 100 to 400 kilojoules per mole. So this slide shows characteristics of chemical absorption. So the molecule chemical absorption intact with the surface area of the adsorbent, or it may dissociate and intact with the surface area of the adsorbent. So that is chemical absorption. This slide shows difference between chemical absorption and physical absorption on the basis of potential energy diagram. So here the delta E for physical absorption process is less than chemical absorption process. So that is, it has a small minima in the case of physical absorption, and in the case of chemical absorption, large minima. That is, in the case of physical absorption, weak van der Waals attraction forces, and in the case of chemical absorption, formation of surface chemical bonds. So the second picture shows the difference between physical absorption and chemical absorption. Here the adsorbent surface area is given, and the adsorbent molecule is CO. How CO in physical absorption, how CO adsorbed in chemical absorption, that is given by this slides. This slide shows differences between physical adsorption and chemical adsorption, that is physical absorption versus chemical absorption. So first one, force of attraction. In the case of physical adsorption, weak van der Waals force of attraction, but in the case of chemical absorption, strong valency forces. And specificity, that is here physical adsorption, that is low, but in chemical absorption that is high. So next, quantity, large amount of adsorbate is absorbed in the case of physical absorption, but small amount of adsorbate is absorbed in the chemical absorption. And the heat effects in both adsorption are exothermic process, that is during adsorption process heat is liberated. So these process, physical absorption and chemical absorption, both are exothermic, but in the case of physical absorption the exothermic delta E value is 1 to 15 kilocalories per mole, but in case of chemical absorption the value is high, 10 to 100 kilocalories per mole. And activation energy in the case of physical absorption, activation energy is low, but in the case of chemical absorption activation energy is high. Now what is activation energy? That is the energy, minimum energy required to form to the process of adsorption here, yeah, this process. So in the case of physical absorption, that is activation energy is low, but in the case of chemical absorption activation energy is high. And the effect of temperature, in the case of physical absorption, rapid at low temperatures and reach equilibrium quickly, that is after a particular temperature there is no adsorption, that temperature is called as critical temperature. But in the case of chemical absorption, the process is slow at low temperature and rate of chemical absorption increases with the temperature. So that is the effect of temperature on physical absorption and chemical absorption. And next one, effect of pressure. So effect of pressure means effect of pressure on adsorption. In the case of chemical absorption, increases with the increase in pressure, but in the case of chemical absorption, pressure is little effect. So next one, surface, whole surface active in the case of physical absorption, but in the case of chemical absorption, fraction of surface only. That means chemical absorption takes place only in the fixed sites. So fraction of surface in the case of chemical absorption is low, fraction only, or certain fraction is involved for chemical absorption. But in the case of physical absorption, whole surface area is involved for the adsorption process. And layers, in the case of physical absorption, multi-layer adsorption takes place. That means more than one layer adsorption takes place. But in the case of chemical absorption, monolayer adsorption, that is only one layer of adsorbate is adsorbed on the adsorbent. That is, these are the differences between physical absorption and chemical absorption. Now next one is adsorption isotherms. So far we have discussed what is meant by adsorption, what is meant by adsorbent, what is meant by adsorbate. Now what is theta, and these are discussed in the previous slides. Now also know what is meant by absorption. Absorption is the bulk phenomena. It is not the surface phenomena. For example, if a sponge is put into water, the water is absorbed by sponge. So that process is called as absorption. So that is, now first we know what is the difference between absorption and adsorption. So absorption is the bulk phenomena and adsorption is the surface phenomena. So in this syllabus, on the adsorption, as the surface phenomena is given, so we have discussed about adsorptions, adsorption, AD, adsorption. So next, adsorption isotherms. Now what is my isotherms? That is, it may be an equation connecting two terms at keeping temperature constant, or it may be a graph which is plotted keeping temperature constant. That is isotherms. That is generally isotherms. So here, for this adsorption process, the equation connecting between two at keeping a constant temperature, that is called adsorption isotherms. Or it may be a graph connecting two or keeping temperature constant. That is adsorption isotherm. There are number of adsorption isotherms. One is Langmuir adsorption isotherms. Another one is Fresnel-Lange adsorption isotherm. Another one is BET, Breyer-Amann-Teller isotherms. All these are discussed, but in the syllabus, Fresnel-Lange adsorption isotherm is not included. So we cannot worry about Fresnel-Lange adsorption isotherm. We start with Langmuir adsorption isotherm. Okay. Now this is this light source Langmuir adsorption isotherm. In Langmuir adsorption isotherm, the equation is derived on the basis of certain assumptions. So Langmuir assumed certain things for its derivations. Now what are the assumptions? Here one layer, monolayer adsorption. There is only one layer is adsorbed. So that is physical adsorption. And another one is uniform. The layer is uniform. Uniform of adsorption. Uniform layer of adsorption. Another one is the gas behaves ideally. That is the adsorbate, that is gas, behaves ideally. And another assumption, that is surface is uniform energetically. So energy wise, the surface is uniform. And here another assumption is all sides are identical, so the adsorption takes place in all sides uniformly. So all sides are identical. So next, another assumption is no interaction between adsorbed molecule and surface. That is no interaction between adsorbate and surface of the adsorbent. And here he assumed adsorption is a dynamic process, consists of two opposing processes. One is adsorption process, another one is desorption process. So a condition of equilibrium is attained during the adsorption process. That is, after the equilibrium there is no adsorption. That means rate of adsorption is equal to rate of desorption at equilibrium. That is another assumption of Langmuir. Another one is amount of adsorbed molecule will not interfere with further adsorption. Amount of adsorbed molecules will not interfere with further adsorption. So these are the various assumptions made by Langmuir. So on the basis of these assumptions, Langmuir derived an equation. That equation is called as Langmuir adsorption isotherm. Now this slide shows derivation of Langmuir adsorption isotherm. So I am considering unit surface area and theta be the area covered by adsorbent. I have already told about theta. So theta is the, now I am considering unit surface area. So total area is unity, and theta be the fraction of area covered by adsorbent. Then what is 1 minus theta? That is 1 minus theta be the area that is not covered by adsorbate molecules. So at equilibrium, theta is the area covered by adsorbate, and 1 minus theta is the area covered by area which is not covered by adsorbate. So now rate of adsorption in the case of adsorption process, it is proportional to pressure and the remaining area, that is area which is bare for adsorption. So that is, these are the two terms. One is pressure, another one is 1 minus theta. These rate of adsorption is directly proportional to these two terms, that is pressure and 1 minus theta. So that is equal to K1P 1 minus theta, that is rate of adsorption. Now rate of desorption directly proportional to area covered by adsorbate. So that is rate of desorption. So that is equal to K2 theta. Now at equilibrium, these two are equal, that is rate of adsorption is equal to rate of desorption. That means when this stage is reached, that is rate of adsorption is equal to rate of desorption, that state, that condition is called as equilibrium. So at equilibrium, rate of adsorption is equal to rate of desorption. So these two equations are equal at equilibrium, that is k1p 1 minus theta, that is equal to k2 theta. From this we can derive the theta 1 by 1, k1p by k2 is equal to theta by 1 minus theta. So by changing 1 minus theta from left hand side to right hand side and k2 from right hand side to left hand side, we get this equation. Now kp, so that is kp is equal to theta by 1 minus theta, where k is equal to k1 by k2. So k1 is the rate constant of adsorption process, k2 rate constant of desorption process. Now both are constants, so k1 by k2, a constant by constant, is equal to another constant. That constant is here, that is cap k, capital K. K is equal to k1 by k2. So now 1 minus theta by theta is equal to 1 by kp. So by inverting left hand side and right hand side, we get this. Now 1 minus 1 by theta minus 1 is equal to 1 by kp. Now 1 by theta is equal to 1 by kp plus 1. That means minus 1 is changed from left hand side to right hand side, it becomes plus 1. So 1 by theta is equal to 1 by kp plus 1. Now 1 by theta is equal to 1 plus kp by kp by taking LCM, very simple. Now theta is equal to, just by inverting, kp by 1 plus kp. Now this is theta in terms of pressure and the constant k. So this slide shows the derivation of up to theta, so according to Langmuir. Now the amount of gas adsorbed per unit mass of adsorbent, that is proportional to theta. So x is the amount of adsorbate adsorbed by m gram of adsorbent. In general, x is the amount of adsorbate adsorbed and m is the mass of adsorbent. So x by m, that is amount of gas adsorbed per unit mass of adsorbent, that is x by m. So this x by m is proportional to theta. So what is theta? Theta is equal to kp by 1 plus kp. So x by m is equal to a proportionality constant k dash and theta, and k, that is equal to k dash kp divided by 1 plus kp. Here k dash is another constant, that is proportionality constant. Now on dividing pressure by this equation, so left hand side pressure by x by m, that is left hand side, and the right hand side pressure divided by k dash p by 1 plus kp, 1 plus kp. So the denominator of the denominator is 1 plus kp. So in mathematically it is on changing numerator, so the equation becomes, first pressure is cancelled in the numerator and denominator, so the equation is 1 plus kp by 1 plus kp by k dash k. First we get this, okay. So next, another by converting this into two terms, that is 1 by k dash plus p by k dash, by cancelling k of numerator and the denominator of the second term. So in the right hand side, what are the terms? We have the two terms. One is 1 by k dash, that is one term. Another term plus p by k dash. So this equation, I have tell this equation once again, p by x by m, that is on the left hand side, and on the right hand side 1 by k dash plus p by k dash. So p by k dash, that is second term. So now this equation is in the form of straight line equation. Now equation 3 is known as Langmuir adsorption isotherm. So p by x by m is equal to 1 by k dash plus p by k dash, that is second term. So that is Langmuir adsorption isotherm. So as this equation is in the form of straight line equation, a plot of p by x by m, that is y, left hand side. So on plotting against pressure should be a straight line. In most cases straight line is obtained, thus Langmuir adsorption isotherm is found to be correct. So left hand side y is p
by x by m. Y is equal to mx plus c. Now what is m? M is the slope of the equation. And what is x? X is the pressure. So on plotting p by x, x by m versus pressure, we get intercept 1 by k k dash and with the slope 1 by k dash. So in most cases, straight line is obtained. Thus, Langmuir adsorption isotherm is found to be correct for most of the cases.
This slide shows graphical graph between p by x by m versus pressure p. So I already told the intercept is 1 by k k dash and slope is 1 by k dash. So that is the effect of pressure on adsorption. Now we have two cases. At low pressure, what is the effect of pressure? So at low pressure, theta is equal to kp by 1 plus kp, that is the Langmuir derived this equation. Theta is derived on the basis of certain assumption, and theta is equal to kp by 1 plus kp. If pressure is low, now in the denominator, in compared with 1, the second term kp is negligible because pressure is low. So kp is negligible in compared with 1. So theta is equal to kp. Numerator only. And that is the extent of adsorption is proportional to pressure. That means kinetically, that is adsorption depends upon only one term, that is pressure term. So kinetically first order. So at low pressure, order of the reaction is adsorption is, order of adsorption is 1. So at high pressure, now theta is equal to kp by 1 plus kp. So now at high pressure, and by considering the new denominator, that is 1 plus kp, 1 is negligible in compared with kp, compared with pressure. So theta is equal to kp by kp, kp by kp. 1 is neglecting 1. Theta is equal to kp by kp, that is equal to 1. That is the extent of adsorption is independent of pressure. That is kinetically zero order. So at high pressure, order of adsorption is equal to 1. At low pressure, order of the adsorption is, at high pressure, order of the adsorption is 0, and low pressure, order of adsorption is 1.